Puccini Tower, blade 6-1. Flight of 3 will taxi to active helicopter runway 13 hotel via X-ray 1 Delta across 8.5. Blade 6. Alright, guys, now I want two. You can taxi up to basically on your left side. The first helicopter is 3, the next one is 1. So I want you to taxi up to sequence with me, and as soon as 2 pass 3, you can start taxiing behind 2.
Copy that.
Copy that. We can keep rolling. 3 can gain the ground on us. We're gonna line up directly at. Usually we hold short, but today's no traffic, so we're gonna line up directly on 13 hotel. Basically, just follow me. It's gonna be a staggered column formation. I will be on the right side, 2 on the left, and 3 on the right side again. And 2, did the Kimkiller inform you about the takeoff procedures?
It was a long time ago.
No worries, there's no traffic today, so we'll just take it nice and slow. And 2, try to position your helicopter so you have the 2 white lines on each side of the wings. I think you can see that from your cockpit, or you are allowed to use F2 view.
Where I'm today, right now.
If you click press F2 and you look at my helicopter, that's you what you wanna, but on the left side, the side you're on, but you want the 2 white lines on each side of the wings. And I'm only being picky so you know what to practice. Alright, this is what's gonna happen. I'm gonna call, and today I'm not gonna call, I'm gonna say informative call that we are taking off. We're gonna enter helicopter pattern. So what I want is a loose trail and just follow me out. We're gonna exit the pattern in downwind, 45 degrees right. So just follow me and I'll say when exit, and just stay in loose trail.
Yep.
Target speed is gonna be 200 kph. I'm gonna call speed all the time. You don't need to roger the speed all the time. I'm just gonna call it so you guys know what to expect. When it comes to the takeoff procedures, now we're gonna do, I'm gonna, normally when you line up, you're just gonna say, for instance, 2, line up ready, 3, line up ready. Once I get that call, I will do the final preparation. I will call tower. Once I get a clearance for tower, I will say flight lift in 5. That means we're gonna lift into a hover shake within 5 seconds. Any questions?
Nope.
When in hover, a roughly 5 meters AGL off ground level, above ground level, you do a quick system check, see that everything works, then you call 2 in the green, 3 in the green. Once that's done, you just wait for my rotate call, and I'm gonna rotate, and you fall in behind me. You can keep a good spacing, but it's up to every flight member now to keep at least one airframe length in between us. Any questions, or do I need to repeat anything?
I'm good to go, too.
Copy. Stand by. Tower Blade 6-1, 3 times key, 51-3 hotel, taking off. Enter helicopter pattern, exit at base 45 degree angle. Blade 6-1. Normally we get this information from tower, but this wind today is 108 at 4 meters per second. Flight lift in 5. And lift. Rotating 5. Rotate. Got a left turn coming up by the building just at my 12 o'clock. Your turn, 30 degrees bank. Left.
Yep.
Sixteen-story building at my nose, next turning point, 30-degree bank, your turn. Exit is bridge, railway bridge, just in Y12. Exiting right. Gear up, smash off, landing light off. I will come into a left turn. Tower Blade 6-1, exit pattern. keep trail formation. We'll establish at 200 kph.
Yep.
Engaging autopilot in. Engaging. Coming up for a right-hand turn, a little bit to correct. Scratch that. Right-hand turn coming up now. Established. 5 meters a second, climb 200 kilometers an hour. Flight veg formation, I want 2 on my left side, 3 on my right side.
Yep.
One leveling out now. Tower blade 6-1, pushing approach 127.2. So long. Flight, push, approach 127.2. Call pushed. Current speed 199. Approach, this is blade 6-1, 3 times K50s at 4,700 feet. Current heading 331 degrees for Tianetti range. Will operate at 5,000 feet and below MSL. Blade 6-1.
What's the frequency again?
127.2. And this is one of the reasons it's good to have them on the left side of you with the buttons externally so you can push them easily. Sometimes we do this 10 meters from the ground in loose trail, 250 kilometers an hour, so it's very can be handy at times.
Absolutely.
This is off-game remark. Does both of you know how a yaw turn works?
A yaw turn is.
It. Some people also calls it the coordinate, the turn.
Oh, okay.
It's basically. One second, problems with my PTT. it's basically you bank, and then you just, after you have the bank in a certain degree, you just use your rudder pedals to turn. It's very easy to maintain speed and altitude by performing the turn this way. Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
So basically when I said yaw turn 30 degrees, then I bank my aircraft 30 degrees, and then I just use the yaw to turn it. So it's very easy for you guys when in a trail, for instance, to keep the same distance to me as we are all. The only thing you need to think about, or almost only, it's a helicopter, of course, so you need to do inputs all the time, but it's the workload is very low on this one, so it's easy to stay in somewhat the formation. Approach late 601 and will exit your airspace to the northwest for a TNT range. Great. Switching to TNT frequency 225.750. Flight push 225.750.
Can you say the frequency again? 225.
225.750.
Two two five seven five zero. I'm blind.
We should be at roughly your 11 o'clock low.
11 o'clock low.
Or 9 o'clock low.
Captain. I'm reading the frequency wrong. When you say 225 decimal, I cannot get 225.
Just keep going upwards. It should switch to uniform from Victor automatically.
User joined your channel.
And negative on that.
Copy that. I can't remember the quick key originally for that because it works when you press the key assigned in Blackjack for it. That afterwards, we'll just go to the backup frequency. One second, I'll look it up.
I got it. I got to do it down on the pit. So what's 225?
750. And don't worry about Mallet, this is why we practice.
Yep.
Approach There's a mean formation there, Solex. And yes, Mallet, you had a great formation before as well. That's how I like it.
So in position.
Two, I still don't have your neighbors.
Okay. Yeah, I don't have you either.
I'll just double check. Five, zero.
No, it's switched to 1-4-5-7-5-0 of some weird reason.
I'll check the backup frequency for TNT. It's a Victor frequency. Yeah, now I got you. Never mind. TNT range 3 times K50s. Enter your airspace from the south southeast. Current flight level 4,700 feet. That heading on 330. We will operate at 5,000 feet and below MSL. As freight. Alright guys, let's pick an open area. One disengaging autopilot. I will come into a right turn.
I'm behind.
Flight 4.
Two in trail.
Speed still 200. Perfect area up ahead. Let's go into a climb as much as this lets us. Alright, let's do a climb 200 kilometers an hour at 5 meters a second. To 6,000, I'll call. Sorry about that. Alright, level out. And bleeding up speed. Nice and slow, doing a 10 degree pitch. One zero zero, I'm bleeding. Five zero, I'm bleeding. And come into a full stop when able. And flight call established. No worries, it happens. That was why I kept a 10-degree bank pitch, because above that on this altitude you usually do. Alright, Solex, I will babble while you get into position. Three, you read that? Okay, what we're gonna do now is simulate one moment that usually happens in almost every live mission. It's when we have fenced in. We're not gonna fence in for this one, but when we have fenced in, lead usually calls low and heavy, or low level, whatever term he uses. And what I usually do is I want to maintain the speed for the reason I explained before, to not gain or lose too much of the room in between the flights, one for not crashing into each other, and obviously two for not going blind if you do it into a dark patch or dark land if it's in the morning. So what we're gonna do is when I call, let's go low level, we're gonna push collective fully down, and then we're just gonna regulate our speed with our cyclic. So speed down, cyclic backwards, speed up, cyclic forward, simple as that. And it's not gonna be, you know, we're not gonna keep exactly the speed all the time, but as long as you're within the perimeter, let's say plus minus 5 is good, plus minus 10 is okay, and you can also regulate if you get too close to one of your wingmen. Any questions?
Nope.
So now I'm gonna pick up speed, you guys fall in, lose a trail. We're gonna push up, target speed will be 250. So I want you to just go on my trail, and once we hit 250 I will at some point call flight go low level, and you just follow my ass in and collective down, control your speed, keep 250 throughout the dive, and that means quite a lot of nose up. So let's do it once, and if it goes well, let's do it again. Flight ready?
Yep.
Once rotating. I will just call speed along the way. 100. One 50. Two 00. Two 50, stabilizing. Got speed warning at 257, so we need to be extra careful when we dive. Two 50 again. Sorry, 3, say again. Oh, I lost it.